باب الوضوء يجب على كل مكلف أن يسمي إذا ذكر ويتمضمض ويستنشق ثم يغسل جميع وجهه ثم يديه مع مرفقيه ثم يمسح رأسه مع أذنيه ويجزئ مسح بعضه والمسح على العمامة ثم يغسل رجليه مع الكعبين وله المسح على الخفين ولا يكون وضوءا شرعيا إلا بالنية.
Did you read up to ولا يكون وضوءا شرعيا إلا بالنية لاستباحة صلاته؟ Did you read it up to there? The author رحمه الله, he now goes into wudu. He goes into what? Al-wudu. What is wudu, brothers? إسال الماء إلى الأعضاء الأربعة معنية. Simple as that. It is to reach the water to all four main limbs of your body. Okay? With what? With an intention. What is the wudu? Wudu is wajib for the salah. Allah says in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِذَا قُمْتُمْ إِلَى الصَّلَاةِ فَاغْسِلُوا وُجُوهَكُمْ وَأَيْدِيَكُمْ إِلَى الْمَرَافِقِ وَامْسَحُوا بِرُؤُوسِكُمْ وَأَرْجُلَكُمْ إِلَى الْكَعْبَيْنِ وَأَرْجُلِكُمْ إِلَى الْكَعْبَيْنِ. Different qira'ah. The wudu is a what? It's a shart, it's a condition. And it's a shart, لا تصح الصلاة إلا بها. أما إلا به. It's a condition. Without it, the salah doesn't exist. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, لا يقبل الله صلاة أحدكم إذا أحدث حتى يتوضأ. Allah will not accept the prayer of a person who has had minor impurity unless he does wudu. Ibn al-Mundhir, he said, أجمع أهل العلم على أن الصلاة لا تجزء إلا بطهارة إذا وجد المرء إليها السبيل. Ibn al-Mundhir said, the scholars and the people of knowledge are unanimously in agreement that the salah is not accepted if a person is able to do tahara and do the wudu. There's no way around that. You have to. So this consensus, there's no difference of opinion. The author says, يَجِبُ عَلَى كُلِّ مُكَلَّفٍ أَن يُسَمَّى إِذَا ذَكَرٍ. The person who's doing wudu, the first thing that's needed from him is to say Bismillah. To say what? To say Bismillah. And the author, rahimahullah, here is referring to the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, where he said, لا صلاة لمن لا وضوء له ولا وضوء لمن لم يذكر اسم الله. The author is referring to the hadith Abu Dawood وغيره narrated it, that there is no salah for the one who has no wudu, and there is no wudu for the one who hasn't said Bismillah. And this hadith, the scholars, they went back and forth. Ahmed, Abu Dawood, and others narrated it. Al-Imam Al-Bukhari أعله بالانقطاع. Bukhari said this hadith is منقطع, it's disconnected. And other scholars like Ibn Mulaqin in his kitab Al-Badr Al-Munir, he said, وَكُلُّ الْرِوَايَاتِ, all of the narrations that have come regarding this particular hadith, لَا يَخْلُو مِن مَقَالٍ. All of them question mark. لكن one of the shuyukhs from Egypt, Abu Ishaq Al-Huwayni, he wrote a risala qayyima, a very beneficial risala on the all the turuq of this hadith. And he brought it together and presented that this hadith is sahih. وَهُوَ كَمَا قَالَ. And it is as he said. So what we say is that the hadith of the hadith of wudu is sahih. It is sahih. Then, if we say it's sahih, it's scary. Because in the hadith it says what? وَلَا وُضُوءَ لِمَنْ لَمْ يَذْكُرِ اسْمَ اللَّهِ. There is no wudu for the person who hasn't said Bismillah. Then, brothers, you should say Bismillah. I mean, you must say Bismillah. From today onwards, when you do your wudu, say Bismillah. And you don't say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Oh, you just say Bismillah. Okay? No one told you to say ar-Rahman, and no one told you to say ar-Rahim. Just say Bismillah. Okay? Just say Bismillah. If a person forgets and is in a state of forgetfulness and doesn't remember to say it, does he then have to repeat it? We will say no. We will say no. Because, especially if he prayed the salah. If he hasn't prayed the salah, he has to repeat the wudu again. But if he's prayed the salah, then Allah says, رَبَّنَا لَا تُؤَاخِذْنَا إِنْ نَسِينَا أَوْ أَخْطَأْنَا. Okay. وَيَتَمَضْمَضُ وَيَسْتَنْشِقُ. The person, what does he do? He does two things, which is al-madmada, wal-istinshaq, wal-istinthar. We're going to add all of that, those three. What does al-madmada means? أَنْ يَجْعَلَ الْمَاءَ فِي فَمِهِ. Place the water in your mouth. That's madmada. And then what do you do? ثُمَّ يُدِيرُهُ. You circulate that water in your mouth. No, don't swallow the water. No, don't swallow it. That water circulates in your mouth, up and down, every part of your mouth. Al-istinshaq is إِدْخَالُ الْمَاءِ فِي الْأَنْفِ. You take the water and you try to put it into your nose. And what do? You try to make that water reach as far as possible, okay? As far as possible. It hurts if you go too far, okay? The Prophet ﷺ, he said in a famous hadith, بَالِغْ فِي الْإِسْتِنْشَاقِ إِلَّا أَن تَكُونَ صَائِمًا. Go as far as making that water reach, but if you're fasting, be careful. When you're fasting, don't. Don't put the water too far. And the other one is الاستنثار. الاستنثار is إخراج الماء من الأنف. It's to bring the water out of your nose. And use which hand? The left hand. So you put the water in your right hand and you bring it out with your left hand. ثُمَّ يَغْسِلُ جَمِيعَ وَجْهِهِ. Then after that, the person washes his entire face. Again, face is what? What is a face? A face is مِنْ أَعْلَى الْجَبْهَةِ. From the top of... It's whatever, when you look at a person, you can see. Can you see here from a person? No, you can't. Okay? So it is whenever a person comes to you face to face, that is called a face. So the scholars, they made it easy. They said, the place where the hair starts from. Okay, up to where, إلى الذقن طولا, to your jaw. And ومن شحمة الأذن, here, until the other ear. So the ard is this and the tool is this. You do that, brothers. And the ulama, they all unanimously agree upon على وجوب غسله, that is obligatory to wash your face. Very good. ثم يديه مع مرفقيه. Then he goes to the hands from the... The hands are two things. If you washed your hands at the beginning when you were starting, then you don't have to do the hands again when you're doing your this. Are we together, brothers? But if you didn't wash it at the beginning, now when you're washing your hands and your arms, your hands have to be in there. So you start from here and you go down. Here the question is, ثُمَّ يَدَيْهِ مَعَ مِرْفِقَيْهِ. It's elbows, right? I know, I was just testing you guys. I don't want to say ankles. Okay, this is your elbows, right? Is the elbows inside there? Do you have to wash the elbows as well? Na'am. The scholars, they differed here, like in. They said, فَغْسِلُوا وُجُوهَكُمْ. Wash your faces. وَأَيْدِيَكُمْ إِلَى الْمَرَافِقِ. They said that the word إِلَى, to, it doesn't mean that the elbows are in there. They said the word إِلَى, it doesn't show. And then the other scholars, they responded and they said, no, it does show with. And our evidence is where Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he said in the Quran, وَلَا تَأْكُلُ أَمْوَالَكُمْ إِلَى, do not eat their wealth and their risk, إِلَى أَمْوَالِكُمْ, إِلَى أَمْوَالِهِمْ, their wealth and your wealth, أي مَعَ أَمْوَالِهِمْ, with, is it أَمْوَالِهِمْ or أَمْوَالِكُمْ? Yeah? وَلَا تَأْكُلُ أَمْوَالَكُمْ إِلَى أَمْوَالِهِمْ, صح؟ أَمْوَالِهِمْ. إِلَى أَمْوَالِهِمْ means أي مَعَ أَمْوَالِهِمْ, with their wealth. So the word إِلَى in the Quran has sometimes meant مَعَ, with. So here it means فَغْسِلُوا وُجُوهَكُمْ وَأَيْدِيَكُمْ إِلَى الْمَرَافِقِ, أي مَعَ الْمَرَافِقِ. It means مَعَ الْمَرَافِقِ, with the elbows in there. And there's actually a hadith where it says that فَغَسَلَ يَدَهُ الْيُمْنَى, the Prophet washed his right hand, حتى أشرع في العضد, until he reached here. صلوات الله وسلام عليه. So it shows that he added the what? The elbows in there. So the elbows fall under the washing. ثم يمسح رأسه. And then the person wipes over their hair. And then the hair is wiping. And so because it's wiping, it's only once. And if you do it twice, it's called washing. If you go on your hair again twice, it's washed. You're washing it now, you're not wiping it. Are we all together? The water that you use for it is once. You've taken that water once, and your hand is balal one time. If you take another water for it again, brother, what are you doing? Are you washing your hair? That's what should be asked. Okay, brothers. The hair or the head?
which one's right? Because a person can might say, I don't have no hair. Yeah, if a person says, I don't have no hair, what do you do? Is it the hair or is it the head? Yeah? I mean, it's easy for you guys to say head and hair. Look, mashallah, barak, you guys all got hair. Hey, yeah. It's both of them. So the word ras means head or hair. Yeah? Ar-ras, does it mean head or hair? Yeah? Okay, if you believe it's head, put your hand up. The head. If you believe it's the hair, put your hand up. If you're mudabdabina bayna dhalik. If you're on neither the side, you're like, I haven't made my mind up, I'm thinking about it, put your hand up. And if you are Allahu A'lam, put your hand up. Those are the good. The Allahu A'lam group is the best. It's the head, brothers. Okay? It's the head. Here's a question. Is it all the head or some of it? And the reason why this argument even came up in the first place is because وَمْسَحُوا بِرُؤُوسِكُمْ the بَاهِيَا in بِرُؤُوسِكُمْ it's disputed. Is it ba at-tab'idiyah or is this ba lil ilsaq? If you say it's lil ilsaq, then you mean the whole entire head should be washed, and that's your qawl. May Allah make it. And if you are of the opinion that it's tab'idiyah, then you believe some of the hair needs to be washed. Which one is? لأن الآية تحتمل هذا وهذا. The ayah can take this meaning and it can take that meaning. So what do we say? What's the situation here, brothers? We'll come to that. This author's going to bring it, so we're not going to go ahead of him. He's going to bring it. Right now he's going to bring it soon. مع أذنيه. You, again, brothers, the water that you brought for the hair is what you use for the ear. You don't bring new water, okay? You don't. How do you wipe over your ears? You do it from outside. Inside, and outside. So you do this. So you put from outside, from the bottom and the outside. Those are the two places that you wipe it. As it was narrated from the hadith of Al-Miqdad ibn Ma'adi Karibin, radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He said that the Prophet ﷺ wiped bira'sihi, his head, wa'udhunayhi, and his ears, zahirihima wa batinihima, the inside and the outside. Both of them he wiped it, salawatullahi wa salamun alayhi. And the way that you need to do it is as I showed you. You put your hands here, one finger inside it, and then you do this, and the one that's inside it, you just wash it like that. Both of them, you do it. وَيُجْزِئُ مَسْحُ بَعْضِهِ Here is the issue now. It is permissible for the person to wipe over some of the head. It is permissible. The author here is wrong. There is no authentic hadith transmitted from the Prophet ﷺ that his hair was showing, that he only wiped over some of his head. مَا وَرَدَ فِيهِ شَيْءٍ I never said that, by the way. I haven't looked at all of the hadiths. The scholars said that. They said that there's no hadith from the Prophet ﷺ that he just did this to the water and khalas, he went. Nothing like that. But what has been transmitted is that the Messenger ﷺ had an imama on, a turban. And what he did was, he wiped over some of the head and then he finished it off on the imama. Are we all together, brothers? That's been transmitted from the Prophet ﷺ, but it hasn't been transmitted from him ﷺ that he only wiped over some of the head. It hasn't been transmitted from him sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And it's also been transmitted from him that he didn't even wipe on his head aslan. He wiped fully on the imama. It has been transmitted from him ﷺ that you don't even do it on your head at all. What do? You can do it on the turban that you're wearing. You don't even do it. It has been transmitted. Are we all together, brothers? And the imama is the turban. So two things have been transmitted from him. That he fully wiped over the imama, and it's also been transmitted from him, salawatullahi wasalamun alayhi, that he what? The nasiyah is the front part of his hair. He wiped over that, and then he finished it off on the turban. That was also transmitted from him. Lakin, him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam only doing part of his hair and not finishing off on anywhere else, there is no evidence for that. ثم after that يغسل رجليه مع الكعبين, the person washes his legs with the heels and with the ankles. صح, you have to. And some people, what they do is they take the washing of the leg very lightly. And how do they do that? They just put their leg under the water and they go. This is wrong. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he one time was traveling. And the Prophet ﷺ was away, and the Sahabas went to do wudu. And then, when they were doing the wudu, they were wiping over their legs, but they were missing some parts. And then the Messenger ﷺ, فنادى بأعلى صوته, he screamed, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And then he said, ويل للعقاب من النار, two times or three times. Okay, Bukhari and Muslim both narrated that. This shows again, sometimes it is permissible. I think Bukhari even chaptered that in his Sahih, when he brought this hadith, the permissibility of the teacher or the person who is educating the people to shout sometimes when there is a need for it, and that it's not bad manners. Okay, so the Prophet raised his voice, alayhi salatu wasalam. He screamed, not at them, but the point, he wanted to bring this point very clear to the companions that, you know, well be to those heels that are not washed. So it's very dangerous. That is very, very dangerous. Make sure that you... وَلَهُ الْمَسْعُ عَلَى الْخُفَيْنِ. Also, you're allowed to wipe over your khufayn. You're allowed to. What takes the place of the khuf, brothers, is the what? The socks. All these conditions that they mention, you have to walk with it that much distance, and if you penetrate, your water can't penetrate. These are shurut مَا أَنْزَلَ اللَّهُ بِهَا مِنْ سُلْطَانِ. You're allowed to wipe over your socks, and you're allowed to wipe over your leather socks. You are allowed to. And it's been transmitted from the Prophet ﷺ, أنه مسح على خفيه, that he wiped over his shoes. صلوات الله وسلام عليه. And what he wiped over is أعلى خفيه, the top part of his shoes. His خف, his socks. Brothers, pay attention to this. It's not considered to be a socks if it's under the heels. Not the heels, sorry, the ankles. If it's below the ankles, you know those sports ones that people wear, you can't wipe over those, by the way. The socks have to be high socks, tall, long socks, okay? And the same with the shoes. If you're wearing shoes that are below your ankles, then they're not considered something you can wipe over. They have to be covering your ankles. Are we all together? That's a condition that the scholars mentioned. Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, لو كان الدين بالرأي, if the religion was based upon opinions, لكان أسفل الخف أولى بالمسح من أعلاه, it would have been, if the religion was based on opinion, آراء and opinions, we would have wiped over the bottom part of the leg of the socks than the top parts, because the bottom part is what you walk on and it's dirty, and the top part is clean, if this religion was opinion. But he said, ولكنني رأيت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, but I saw the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم يمسح على ظاهر الخف, but what I saw was that he wiped over the top. Then this religion is not about opinions and I think and I assume. It's قال الله قال رسوله. Allah said and His Messenger said. العلم قال الله قال الرسول قال العلم قال الله قال الرسول. Then Ibn al-Qayyim said that knowledge is Allah said and His Messenger said. And it's not the speech of Alan and Fulan, what they said. Okay? What is the condition for al-mas'u al-khufayn? What is the condition for me to? أن تلبسهما على طهارة. You have to wear them upon a state of tahara. So when you wore it, you were pure and in a state of tahara. And the evidence for that is the hadith al-Mughira, where the Prophet said, دعوهما فإني أدخلتهما طاهرتين. Leave them, I wore them when I was in a state of tahara. How long is it that the person can wipe over? If you're a resident and you're in your place of residency, yawmun wa layla, a day and a night, 24 hours. If you're a traveler, thalathata ayyamin wa layalihinna, 3 days and three nights. 3 days and what? Three nights. Wa la yakun wudu'an shar'iyyan illa bi niyyati li sibahati salah. The author then said, it will not be a wudu' in the sharia unless you come with an intention. So a person can't just do wudu without no intention, because of the hadith, إِنَّمَا الْعَمَالُ بِالنِّيَّاتِ. نعم.
فَصْلٌ فِي مُسْتَحَبَّاتِهِ وَيُسْتَحَبُّ التَّثْلِيثُ فِي غَيْرِ الرَّأْسِ وَإِطَالَةُ الْغُرَّةِ وَالتَّحْجِيلِ وَتَقْدِيمُ السِّوَاكِ وَغَسْلُ الْيَدَيْنِ إِلَّا الرُّسْغَيْنِ ثَلَاثًا قَبْلَ الشُّرُوعِ فِي غَسْلِ الْأَعْضَاءِ الْمُتَقَدِّمَةِ.
The author now talks about what is recommended. He's spoken about what you have to do. Now he's going into what is recommended. The author, rahimahullah, he mentions that it's recommended tathleeth three times. That the person does every part of the body three times. It's highly recommended. Three times. It's recommended. And it's also been transmitted from the Prophet ﷺ that he done it twice. And it's also transmitted from him that he done it once. وَالْوَاجِبُ مَرَّةً وَاحِدًا. And one is obligatory. One is obligatory. لَكِنْ وَالْأَكْمَلْ. That which is most completest is ثلاث غسلات. Three times. Other than what? The head. The head you don't do three times. Nor do you do two times. How many times do you do your head? Once. And the ear is with the head. You only do both of them once. Also, what is recommended is وَإِطَالَةُ الْغُرَّةِ وَالتَّحَجِيلِ. It is highly recommended that the person slightly just goes a bit up from their elbows. Just go up. And also, your legs. Highly recommended. Just to be on the safe side. Don't go too much to the armpits. Okay? Just go a bit up. Because of the Prophet ﷺ said, إِنَّ أُمَّتِي يَأْتُونَ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ غُرَّا مُحَجَّلِينَ مِنْ آثَارِ الْوُضُوءِ. Then Abu Hurairah added on to, فَمَنِ اسْتَطَاعَ أَنْ يُطِيلَ غُرَّتَهُ فَلْيَفْعَلْ. That is mudraj. It's the call of Abu Hurairah. That my ummah will come the day of judgment, غُرَّا مُحَجَّلِينَ مِنْ آثَارِ الْوُضُوءِ. The places of your wudu will be illuminating the day of judgment. So what you need to do is try your best to do that. وَتَقْدِيمُ السِّوَاكِ. And it's also recommended just before you start your wudu that you precede it with a wudu. With a siwak. Because of the hadith, لولا أن أشق على أمتي لأمرتم بالسواك عند كل وضوء. And Imam al-Bukhari narrated it مُعَلَّقًا بِسِيغَةِ الْجَزْمِ. And also Malik and Ahmed and others have narrated in hadith Abi Hurairah. لولا أن أشق على أمتي. If I was not fearful for my ummah, I would have commanded them to use the siwak at every time of wudu. وغسل اليدين إلى الرسغين ثلاثا قبل الشروع في غسل الأعضاء المتقدمة. The رسغ is مفصل ما بين الكف والساعد. It's here. Some scholars, they say it's here, which is the one I just mentioned, right here. Between here and here, just in the middle. Anyways, is to just make the hands, when you're washing it, you add this into it. Just go a bit up. Just do that much. Okay? Do that to be on the safe side.